Points A and B are 150 kilometers apart. Draw this. A here, B here, 150 kilometers. Cars 1 and 2 travel from A to B. But car 2 travels from A when car 1 is already 20 kilometers from A. So car 1 starts first, then car 2 starts. Each car travels at a speed of 100 kilometers per hour for the first 50 kilometers, 50 kilometers per hour for the next 50 kilometers, and 25 kilometers per hour for the last 50 kilometers. The distance in kilometers between car 2 and B when car 1 reaches B is, so car 1 starts, and so for the first 50 kilometers we travel at 100 kilometers per hour. So I'm going to break this into three parts. 50 50 50. Fine. So when car 1 is 20 kilometers ahead, that is when car 2 begins the journey. And car 1 is 20 kilometers ahead, that's when car 2 begins the journey. Think about this. Car 1 is 20 kilometers away from A. Car 1 travels at a speed of 100 kilometers per hour for the first 50 kilometers. So for the first 20 kilometers, car 1 would have taken 20 by 100 kilometers per hour, which is whatever, 1 by 5 of an hour. Fine, so 12 minutes. Now car 2 starts 12 minutes behind car 1. So car 2 will be 12 minutes behind car 1. Finally, when car 1 reaches here, car 2 will be at a point where it's going to reach in 12 minutes. Right? This is the last stretch. It's traveling at 25 kilometers per hour. Traveling at 25 kilometers per hour and another 12 minutes to reach, or the distance is 25 into 1 by 5. 25 kilometers per hour into 1 by 5, or 5 kilometers. Another way to think about it, a beautiful way to think about it. Car 1 takes some amount of time, started some amount of time ahead here. Car 2 is going to travel this leg. The amount of time car 1 travels this 20 kilometers is the amount of time car 2 will have to travel here. Car 1 travels this 20 kilometers at 100 kilometers per hour. Car 2 has to travel this last leg at 25 kilometers per hour. The time taken should be the same, because car 2 is chasing car 1 and it starts car 1 after that time. Their entire journeys are identical. The trips they take is identical. For taking 20, the speed is 4 is to 1. So if you're traveling 20 kilometers here, the gap remaining should be 5 kilometers. The time car 2 takes to travel the last 5 kilometers, it should be equal to the time car A takes to travel the first 20 kilometers. That's the time gap between A and B. Think about it. If car 1, between 1 and 2, if car 1 started, say, 46 minutes before car 2, car 2 will reach 46 minutes after car 1. They're traveling identical trips. I'm not saying the answer is 46 minutes. I'm saying some T minutes. Car 1 starts ahead. Car 2 will end exactly T minutes after that. So they're traveling the same distance, the same pattern. So that's all we need to keep in mind for this question.